All right. I'm going to start the music and we're going to get started in child pose. So when you're ready, go ahead and take your knees about mat distance. I'm so grateful to be here with you tonight. I'm Katie from Charlotte Yoga as part of this exclusive class for BCO employees and customers. So just kind of move into stillness, everybody. Start to walk your hands off one side of the mat and the other, maybe. In child's pose, I'd like you to take three big breaths into your belly. And your belly will expand as you breathe in, but so will your backside body, keeping the shoulders relaxed. And as you exhale, soften your face, your hips. Pause at the bottom with your lungs empty just for a moment before you start to inhale again from the very bottom all the way to the very, very top. And just notice how these deeper breaths are making you feel as all the things we've been doing start to fall away. And all the thoughts we've been thinking start to lose their grip. And we become fully present with the quality of this breath in. And this breath out. So for your next breath, take the biggest breath you've taken all day long, from the very bottom, the pit of the belly, all the way to the top. Hold the lungs full, create some tension, keep the shoulders relaxed though. And then just sigh, especially if no one can hear you, make some noise. Let's slowly press to all fours. From here, let's do a couple of hip circles. Flex your right ankle, bend your right knee, and circle around one way, and then the other. Restoring active blood flow after the compression and stretch. Once you do that a couple of times on each side, line up knees and hips, wrists and shoulders, and follow your full exhale to round the spine. Pushing into the fingers, pulling the belly tight, tuck your chin, cat pose. Inhale, arch the spine, draw the shoulders back, chin and tailbone lifting, cow pose. You might close your eyes so you can really feel how your spine is doing today. Every day is different. Some days we're a little more tense than others. And after you do that a couple of times, flip your fingers around to face your body and then start to round your spine a little here, taking two or three full rounds of breath into your wrist and forearm. After you do that, we'll slowly begin to make our way to our plank position. So extending your legs back, of course, option to hold your knees down plank. Knees down plank is still really hard. And I'll have you start to distribute the weight around. So we tend to kind of dump weight into our wrists. Let's avoid that, friends. Let's push weight into the fingers. Let's have the thumbs toward the center, a little micro bend in the elbows. Spread your shoulder blades apart and pull your belly really tight together. Give your kneecaps a good lift and squeeze. And just notice how you're feeling right now in your plank position. If you're having any thoughts of wanting it to be over, see if you can interrupt those thoughts with thoughts of how you're breathing. Maybe as you inhale, think inhale. And as you exhale, think exhale. Take one more good breath. Bend your knees, shift back, strong work, downward facing dog. Point those fingers slightly out to the front corners of the mat. Plank pose is a yoga posture. Nod your head lightly, yes. Lightly, no. Move into stillness. I'd rather your heels be lifted and your knees be bending a little bit than you to feel like you're rounding a lot in your low back. My heels are definitely lifted here in this first dog. Knees intentionally bent. Let's walk that left foot a little closer toward the center. Right toes point down. Inhale to 3-point stretch. Point and flex your right ankle as you wrap your left outer hip back and up. And then we'll open up the right hip, bend the right knee, find your scorpion tail, and then roll out the ankle as you twist your belly button slightly to the left. High on your right toes, pull your right knee straight down the center, cheetah pose. Now push into your hands with the same amount of effort that you pull your knee in. One more breath, you can do it. Get back to plank, option to hold, option to drop your knees and fold, option to take 1 to 3 push-ups. You don't have to do any push-ups. You can do 1 push-up. We'll meet on the belly when you're done. Reach your arms back, look down and forward, locust, lift up 1/3 of the way, come down just a little bit, lift up 2/3 of the way, come down just a little bit. We've trained the spine what to do. Lift up to your highest point and hold. Try not to clench your glutes together. Instead, roll your pinky toes down a little bit. Lift your chest, use your spine, you can. Exhale, slowly release. Nice work, tuck your toes. Inhale to knees down, plank or plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Remember those knees are bending and your heels are lifted. Walk your right foot a little closer to center. We'll hold left leg. Inhale to 3 points. And we point and flex the left ankle as you wrap your right outer hip up and back. Open up your left hip, bend your left knee. Start to roll your ankle as you twist your belly button slightly to the right. High on your right toes, try pulling your left knee straight down the center. And again, try pushing into your hands with the same amount of energy you pull your knee in. So strong, step back to plank, option to hold, to drop your knees and hold, or to take 1 to 3 push-ups. And again, you never have to do push-ups. Even just doing 1 or 2 will make you stronger if you're up for it. Reach your arms out like a T when you're ready. Lift up about 1/3 of the way. Still kind of training our spine what to do. Come down a little bit. Lift up a little higher than you just were. And come down, lift up to your highest point. Now put your mind in your shoulder blade. Circle your shoulder blade, and then you'll feel your hands moving. But don't think about moving your hands. Think about moving your shoulders and switch the direction. I know that's kind of a lot to ask, but just set the intention and stop with those circles and lift to your highest point. So nice. Exhale, come down, tuck your toes. Inhale to plank or knees down plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe in, big inhale. Clear out. All right, y'all, let's walk our feet about mat distance. Bend your knees a little, walk your hands about halfway up your mat towards your feet, touch your thumbs together. Then take your right hand to the out edge of the left ankle or calf. And for a little stretch, start to look under your left armpit. No need to overdo it. Switch release, thumb touch, little half lift. Left hand outside that right ankle or shin. And release, walk your hands all the way back to your feet. Inhale, half lift, shoulders draw back. Let's drop into ragdoll. Just dangle here at the back of your mat a little bit. Maybe nod your head, sway. Maybe feeling like your energy's coming up a little bit. You can start to release any binds. Keep your feet nice and wide. Walk out to a plank position with wide feet and lift both of your kneecaps in a yoga way. Right hand taps the front of the left shoulder. You can do this. Left hand taps the front of the right. Feel free to bring your knees down. Right arm reaches forward. Left arm reaches forward. You got this. Lower right elbow down. Last thing. Left elbow down. Press up right palm. Left palm. Shift back. Downward facing dog. Walk your feet closer to hip distance. Take a big breath in. And just sigh. And we'll lift the feet. Take 8 to 10 tiny steps. An intentionally slow way to travel to the top of the mat. When you get there, inhale, half lift. This is about spine health, so don't skip it. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise up, sweep your arms high. Exhale, hands to heart. Take a big breath in and out. Inhale, arms sweep up, look up. Exhale, bend your knees, dive forward slow. Half lift, inhale. Exhale, right foot back, lunge. Inhale, left foot back, plank. Exhale to lower, could be knees first, could be chaturanga. Inhale to lift, could be up dog, cobra, or some kind of plank variation. Exhale, downward facing dog. You take two full rounds of breath, and I'll demo a couple of those different options as we roll through. So I just did a knees test pin to cobra. Bottom of your exhale, look forward, heels up. Bend your knees, step or jump, feet to top of mat. Half lift, inhale, fold, exhale. Inhale, rise, maybe back bend a little, maybe reach straight to the sky. Exhale, fold from hips and waist. Half lift, inhale, left foot back, exhale, lunge. Right foot back, inhale, plank. Exhale to lower, elbows and shoulder heads back. Inhale to lift. I just did chaturanga to up dog. Follow the full length of your exhale back to dog and take two more full rounds of breath after that. And notice how challenging or how easy it feels to breathe easily as you move, maybe even through some harder transitions and postures. Bottom of your next exhale, look forward, heels up, bend your knees, step or jump, feet to top. Half lift, inhale, fold, exhale. Inhale, rise, maybe back bend, maybe grow very tall. Last on A, exhale, fold. Half lift, breathe in, palm the mat, step, jump, or float. Take vinyasa, or you can skip it. Remember, it can always look like a push-up or a knees down push-up. Remember, inhale, lift, exhale, dog. It's the perfect amount of breath. And that would be a little easier on the fronts of the shoulders, should you feel like you need that. So from here, we'll finish what we started, optional strength. If you prefer, you can hold down dog, you can hold plank, or you can even hold child's pose. Let's take the feet a little wider and a little further back, maybe, then shift forward to high plank position and finish what we started. Make sure those kneecaps are nice and lifted. And in a yoga way, left hand touches the front of the right shoulder. You got it. Right hand touches the front of the left. Left arm reaches far forward. Right arm reaches far forward. Lower left elbow down. You can. Right elbow down. Press up left palm. Right palm, walk your feet into hip distance. Take a big inhale and plank. Exhale to lower or not, vinyasa or skip it. Inhale to lift. Up dog, tops of feet down, inner thighs up. When you come back to your dog, again, notice how easily the breath is flowing. Maybe you want to slow it down a little bit or pause at the bottom of your exhale if you feel like your heart rate has gotten a little high. But it is okay for your heart rate to go up a little bit. Bottom of your next exhale, we'll look forward. Lift your heels, bend your knees, step or jump, feet to top of mat. Top lift, inhale. Fold, exhale, inhale, rise, sweep up, grab that left wrist with your right thumb and forefinger, lift to the sky, belly is tight, lean over to the right and let it feel good. Right shoulder under, left hip forward. Inhale, center, swap your wrist, lift up tall, belly together, lean to the left. Right hip forward, left shoulder under this time. Inhale, center, lift up tall, maybe back bend a little. Bend your knees, exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift, shoulder heads draw back. Separate your feet to fist width distance apart and bend your knees a little. Grab hold the back of those calf muscles and keep your elbows pointed behind you. Do a half lift, and maybe your belly is touching your thigh. That would be ideal if you can. Then drop your head, and keeping your belly touching your thigh, just lift your butt a little bit. And maybe curl your chin under. So we're not quite to hands to feet pose. We're about halfway there. We'll get there maybe in this class, maybe in next lifetime. It's all good. one more breath. And then as you inhale, half lift, don't skip that. Walk your feet in a little closer. Fold, exhale. Bend your knees and sit back in chair. And then interlace your hands behind your head in chair pose. Lean the back of the head into the hands, and then your front low ribs flare out. So pull your front low ribs back in, and then sit down just a little more, and you'll find yourself leaning forward. So lean back again into your hands, then pull your front low ribs back in, then sit down even further. Now reach your arms up, and this should feel challenging and awkward. The name of this posture, chair pose, is actually awkward pose. So squeeze those inner thighs, sit back a little bit deeper, take a big inhale, you can. Exhale, open twist to the right, belly button twist slightly to the left. Great, inhale to center, take your time. Exhale, open twist left, belly button twist slightly to the right. Inhale, center, sit as low as you can. Three, breathe, two, exhale, forward, fold. Nice work. Half lift, inhale. Separate your feet like a little wider than your hips for yoga squat. Point your toes out and slowly send your butt down. So you might need a block if you're lucky enough to have one. You might be up here. That's totally fine. Just sit as low as you can. Lift your chest up as high as you can. Then reach your right hand out to the right, in front of your right knee, and your left arm up and over to the left, just for a moment, one good breath. Come back to center, pause, bring your palms together, lift upright through the top of the head, and then bring your left hand out to the left, in front of the left knee, reach your right arm up and over to the right. Come back to center. Lift through the top of the head, create just the crow shape. You do not have to be able to do crow pose. So you'll place your hands down, shoulder distance, lift your hips halfway, and walk your big toes to touch each other. Split your knees and take them as high as you can towards your armpit. Then bend your elbows and lean forward. The further forward you lean, the lighter your toes become. When your toes feel light, push into your fingers and puff your upper back. If you're feeling okay, maybe lift one toe and then the other. Otherwise, just stay. If you're feeling super okay, maybe you lift both heels, squeeze them tight to your butt. Maybe you need a break, you'll come back to that squat. We'll step back or float back, and you can jump back from the squat. Whenever you're ready, vinyasa or skip it. You can always skip it, or it could always be that push-up or plank on your way to downward facing dog. Customize your practice to your body and to your knees. Take a big breath in, big breath out. Left leg, start with your left leg. Inhale, 3 points. Exhale, mountain climber on the left, left knee to left elbow. Option to hold if you're feeling super okay. Option to elevate your left knee up and down your left forearm. No pressure. 3 point inhale, left toes point down. Exhale, cross cheetah, left knee to the right elbow, hold. Revolve side plank, extend your left leg out and then reach your right arm up to the sky. Pushing the left hand into the ground. Exhale, right hand comes down. Left knee, pull it in. Use all the time you need. Cheetah, step up. Warrior one, right heel down. Inhale to rise. And just pause here for a moment in warrior one. Don't worry about hip square. My right hip is pointed kind of 45 degrees. Left hip is pointed forward. Take a big inhale. We'll take a posture called easy twist. Exhale, right hand down on your right toes. Inhale, left arm high. Keep the top of the head forward. Stay here, one more breath. Left outer hip wrapping back. Exhale, left hand down, runner's lunge. Push off your left heel. Inhale, crescent lunge. Left outer hip is working now. Exhale, warrior two, readjust your feet. You got this. Inhale, peaceful warrior. Hold your left knee out to the left as you reach back. Exhale, modify extended side angle. Now we'll hold here for 5 breaths. It's a pause, but we're pausing while in a challenge. I want you to notice if you can still breathe easily, even when you feel challenged. Skill set. We'll sit a little lower. Hug your feet towards each other. Hold from the middle and float your left elbow up off of your left knee. And then reach your left arm out as far as you can. Rotate your chest to the right. And from the right side body, lift up to straight leg people. Oh, release. Triangle on the left to the top of the mat. Hips go slightly right as you reach your left arm forward. So you can kind of feel that one moves one way, the other moves the other way. Hips right, left arm left, right arm straight up to 12 o'clock. Always trying to stay strong in the middle. So outer hip, core, everything engaged. Take one more breath and lengthen through the top of your head. Again, squeeze from the right side body. Inhale, windmill up to straight leg peaceful. Point your toes to the side mat for goddess squat. Bring your heels in and your toes out. Bend your knees and squat down. So my toes pointing to the front and back of the mat. Knees kind of track with the toes. Interlace your hands behind your head, just like we did in chair. And you'll lean back. It's okay if you feel like you're gonna fall a little bit. Pull your front low ribs in and sit down. I have fallen out of bed. Lean back. We'll try not to. Pull your front low ribs in and sit down. Awesome. Now from here, you got this. Lift your left heel off the mat just for a second and slowly lower it. Then lift your right heel up off the mat just for a second and slowly lower it. Now both heels at the same time, just for a millisecond. Slowly lower them. Push your weight into both heels evenly. Then lean back, head into hands, risen, sit down, reach your arms as high as you can for 5. Shoulders away from the ears. Try to soften the face and the breath, even if you feel challenged. Push into your heels, stand up so slow. Warrior 2 on the right, to the back of the mat. Left toes point to the side mat, right toes point to the back of the mat. Hold your right knee out to the right a little bit as you inhale back to peaceful warrior on the right. Exhale, modify extended side angle. Right elbow lands on your right knee. Left arm reaches long over your head. 5. Keep holding your right knee out to the right. It'll wrap your right hip under you a little more. And unclench your toes. And float your right elbow up off of your right knee. And reach your right arm out. Nice and slow. Rotate your chest open to the left. From your left side body, windmill up. Straighten your right leg. Triangle on the right to the back of the mat. So hips pop slightly left as your right arm reaches forward. Right hand to your shin, left arm to the sky. Hold for 5. Squeeze your outer hip. Lengthen through the top of your head. Holding that left side body so strong. Slowly inhale, windmill up from the middle. Toes to the side mat, hands to your waist. Let's take a wide-legged fold. Lift your chest, bend your knees, and slowly fold down. Walk your hands out in front of you. From here, you have choices. You can do a half lift, and you can just hold and fold. Or you can work a twist. You could bring your right hand out in front of your face. Bring your left arm up and twist your belly button towards the ground, towards the right hand. And if you take the twist, keep lengthening through the top of your head. Mm-hmm. We'll all meet if you're moving even around through both sides in this half lift and walk your feet in a little closer, about 6 inches. Pivot around to pyramid stance on the left to the top of the mat. So left toes pointed forward, right toes out at 45 degrees. Come all the way up to standing and try to get both of those hips pointed straight forward. From here, we'll come about halfway down. Pull your belly together. And then you'll have the top of your head lengthening forward, left outer hip going back. Slowly bring your hands down. Long stance pyramid or intense stretch. Take a second here, chest drop, head drop. And feel free to stay here a little longer. If you'd like revolve triangle, bring your right hand down, right fingertip down. Left hand to your left outer hip, rotating your left shoulder open. Left arm to the sky, top of the head forward. Awesome work. Bend your left knee, left hand comes down, step back to plank. Option to hold, option to take vinyasa, option to skip it all together. Of course, you can skip it. We'll meet in downward facing dog for a big breath in. Big breath out. When you're ready, right leg, 3-point, inhale. Exhale, mountain climber, hold here. If you're feeling super okay, maybe elevator your right knee up and down your right forearm. 3-point inhale, right toes point down. Exhale, cross cheetah, right knee to the left elbow, hold. Start to straighten your right leg out and then lift to revolve side plank. So right hand is down, left arm is up and you're pushing the ground away and lifting your hips. Slowly bring your left hand back down, pull your right knee into cheetah, and then step up to crescent lunge. Inhale to rise. Awesome, easy twist. Warrior one. Left heel down, arms up. Solid in both feet, and now easy twist. Exhale, left hand down on your left toes. Inhale, right arm high. We'll feel that right outer hip wrapping back. Top of the head, lengthening forward. Exhale, right hand comes down, runner's lunge. Push off your right heel, inhale to crescent. Feeling that right outer hip now. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, peaceful warrior. Maybe catch a half bind. Exhale, full extended side angle on the right to the top of the mat. Maybe you keep that half bind. Maybe you do no bind, traditional. I like the right hand outside of the foot here. Pressing the outside of the knee into the inside of the right arm to keep the right outer hip activated. If you would like some kind of half bind or full bind, you're of course welcome to do that. But you absolutely do not have to have any kind of bind. If you did start to unwind those binds, stay low in your lunge. Inhale, peaceful warrior. Straighten your right leg, sweet relief. Right toes to the side mat. Left toes to the back of the mat. Bend your left knee and sit into warrior two on the left to the back of the mat. Hold for a moment. Left knee out to the left hip wrapping under you. Sit just a little lower. Hug your heels towards each other like there's a magnet pulling them together. Inhale, peaceful warrior, maybe catch the half bind. Full extended side angle on the left to the back of the mat. Same that you just took on the other side. Maybe it was no bind. Right shoulder away from your right ear if the arm is overhead. And again, if the hand is outside the foot, pressing the hand or the inside of the left arm into the outside of the left thigh and knee to activate this left outer hip. If you've got any kind of bind here, you might slowly start to unwind it. Sit low in the lunge, push solid in your left heel. And as you inhale, peaceful warrior, straighten your left leg, slowly left toes to the side mat. optional bind for this wide-legged fold. Interlace your hands, bend your knees, and drop down nice and slow. And you don't have to do this bind. You can do a half lift and lose the bind and do side-to-side lunges or headstand or whatever you'd like to do. If you do still have the bind, maybe do another half lift and drop back in. Notice how you're breathing. If you do still have the bind, do a half lift, and when your hands meet your low back, release it. We'll all meet with the hands out in front, doubling down on the half lift. Walk your feet about 6 inches closer towards each other, and then pivot around to pyramid stance on the right to the top of the mat. Slowly rise all the way to standing. Get your hips nice and square. Come about halfway down. Right outer hip wraps back top of the head, lengthens forward. And as you slowly come down, keep your right hip wrapping back. Keep your chest moving forward. Release your head last. You can stay here as long as you'd like, or you can take your right hand to the outside of your right hip. Top of the head forward, right arm up to the sky. Keep lengthening through the top of the head. One more good breath. Exhale, right hand comes down. Bend your right knee. Step back to plank. Optional vinyasa. Maybe knees down push-up. We'll meet in that downward facing dog. Take a good breath in. And sigh. Here we go. Right leg. Inhale. 3 points. Exhale, cheetah. Step up, crescent lunge, inhale to rise. Micro bend your left knee, push off your right heel, stork on the left. Figure four, flex your left ankle, sit back, bring your hands to your heart, or reach forward a little bit, or maybe place your elbows on your knees. Sit down a little, come back to stork. Slowly exhale to arrowhead. Bring your hands down, runner's lunge, drop your left knee and shift back, half split, so good. And we'll just kind of go back and forth between low lunge and half split. Little floss for the hamstrings, landing in your half split when you're ready. And you'll think right hip back, left hip forward, chest moving forward. Keeping a micro bend in your right knee. When you're ready, bend your right knee. Come to lizard. Wiggle your right heel to the outer edge of the mat. Push to the inside of the right knee. Option to walk your hands out or drop your left elbow. Release your head and take a few good breaths. Easy in, easy out. I'm gonna start to change our music here. When you're ready, we'll press up onto those palms. Tuck your left toes, lift your left knee, step back to plank. Optional vinyasa, optional 3 push-ups if you want extra. Optional skip it if you need a little less. We'll meet in downward facing dog for a big breath in. Big breath out. Last thing, left leg. Inhale, 3 points. Exhale, cheetah. Step up, crescent lunge. Inhale, to rise. Micro bend your right knee, push off your left heel, stork on the right. Flex your right ankle, sit down, figure four. Hands might be at heart, might be reaching forward. You had the range of motion, you might rest your elbows. Try to keep your heart uplifted. Sit a little lower, inhale to stork. Exhale to arrowhead, land lightly. Inhale, hands down, runner's lunge, drop your right knee, shift back, half split, low lunge block. Go back and forth a few times. And we'll land in the half split. Right hip forward, left hip back. Chest forward, easy breathing. Staying here as long as it feels good, or bending your left knee, wiggling your left heel out to the left for lizard, pushing to the inside of the knee, walking the hands out or dropping the elbows down. I've been paying attention a lot to how I'm breathing when I feel challenged. And not just during the physical challenge of an exercise or a yoga workout, but during challenging situations in my life. Because the way we do anything is the way we do everything. Press up onto your palms, tuck your right toes, last chance for vinyasa, step back to plank. I'm going to do a knees, chest, chin to cobra. We'll meet in downward facing dog, last dog of class. Breathe in through the nose and sigh. Then look forward, lift your heels, bring your feet forward, cross your ankles, come onto your back. We'll do bridge pose, line your heels under your knees, lift your hips off the mat, roll the tops of your shoulders here. Push your heels down, lift your bum, and breathe. The way we do anything is the way we do everything. Then if we practice breathing well and we feel physically challenged in yoga, hopefully we will breathe well during all of our challenges. Start to lift your heel, release your hands, slowly lower your spine, one vertebral joint at a time. Gently windshield wiper your knees, and then pull your knees together into your chest. Give yourself a big squeeze, and drop your knees over to the left for a spinal twist. Soft and easy breathing on the other side of the challenge. Next exhale, rock to your left side, come onto your back. Slowly let your knees drop over to the right. Chin and left arm to the left, adjust as needed. Learning how to be graceful and have equanimity when things feel hard. Rock to your right side, come onto your back, find happy baby, our last posture before we rest. It was always important for us to breathe through challenges. Now it feels vital. So taking all the time you need to land in your final resting posture, could be Shavasana, or if you have a history of low back issues, could be knees together, feet wide. When you do land there, take one last clearing breath, fill up to the brim, and sigh, letting it all resonate in the cells and in the spirit. Shavasana.
before you move, breathe down into your belly.
And let this deeper breathing evolve into gentle moving, eventually towards a full body stretch. Now bend your knees one at a time. You can lie here on your back or rock to your favorite side. We're on a slow journey to an upright seat. Bring your hands together at your heart. Cross the thumb that feels strange on top. Take a big inhale, sit up tall. Sigh. Bring your thumbs between your eyebrows. And feel the difference. We honor all the light in one another. Namaste, Hiko. Thank you for your time, energy, tonight.